Lamborghini India has witnessed its highest ever sales in 2021, according to a recent report. The Italian automaker has surpassed the record yearly sales of 52 units, which was achieved during the 2019 calendar year. As of now, the total number of cars sold this year between January and November 2021 have not been revealed. However, the company did announce crossing the 300-unit sales milestone in India earlier this year since it began operations. Out of the 300 units sold in the country so far, more than 100 units were sold just in the last 2 years itself. Lamborghini's demand has surged in recent years with the arrival of the Urus Performance SUV that is currently the company's global bestseller. Harley-Davidson has entered into a partnership with Taiwanese manufacturer Kuangyang Motor Company or KYMCO, as the companies will collaborate to develop electric vehicles in the future. KYMCO will be investing $100 million into LiveWire, Harley-Davidson's electric motorcycle division, and AEA Bridges Impact Corporation, a special purpose acquisition company, which will combine to form a newly publicly traded company. Once the deal is completed, LiveWire will be the first publicly traded electric motorcycle company in the United States. Harley will also be investing $100 million into the new venture. LiveWire is a sub-brand from Harley-Davidson and will focus on developing and building electric offerings. KYMCO will be bringing its engineering expertise, manufacturing footprint, distribution, supply chain infrastructure, and global logistic capabilities to the table in this partnership. The government's push for alternative fuel and flex fuel technology is well known to us, and it seems we are now closer than ever to having flex fuel engines in mass market cars. Recently, Union Minister Nitin Gadkari said that the government has advised automakers to start developing and manufacturing flex fuel powered vehicles, hybrid and electric vehicles that comply with the BS6 emission norms within 6 months from now. This move will drastically reduce greenhouse gas emissions from vehicles and in turn will help the country meet the COP26 commitments, the transport minister added further. Nitin Gadkari has been advocating the benefits of alternate fuels to the environment and how they are more cost effective. The minister had been requesting automakers to switch to or incorporate natural gas alternatives like methanol and ethanol, among others, which are comparatively less polluting. Flex fuel engines can run on more than one fuel, and the government says that it can help reduce India's oil import bills.
We simply love, love, love hearing from you, so your comments and feedback are important. Subscribe to our channel, react to this video, and of course, watch our other videos too.